Praise the Lord, and welcome to today's airing of The Access, where conversation is key. Once again, it's a great blessing to be able to come to you through these means and be able to communicate everything that God is doing throughout His kingdom. The Access has always been looked at as a way of kind of seeing behind the curtain and getting to know a little bit more of our leaders, of our folks that are directing different areas within the church and just leading the church in different areas and different aspects. And today is a great blessing to have a great friend of ours, a personal friend as well, Bishop Sam Rojas. He is our Secretary of Social Assistance. Now he's the Secretary of Social Assistance, but we've known each other for quite a while. His family is a great blessing to my family, and we just thank God for this opportunity of having him here with us today and taking the time to be with us. Bishop Sam, thank you for being with us today.
Thank you, Pastor Marty. It's such an honor to be here with you today, and as you mentioned, you and I go way, way back to our childhood, and it's great to be at the Access today, and thank God for your ministry and this program.
Amen. Thank you, Bishop. Thank you. Well, let's jump right into it.
Sure.
let's just jump in the deep end of the pool right now. So as you mentioned, I've mentioned, we've known each other for quite a while. We're not as young as we used to be, but God has blessed us along the way. It's interesting because we kind of went our separate paths at a pretty young age, mm-hmm. In different areas, always in ministry, always in work. We met and came together in Compton, California, where my dad was pastoring, and you all were members of the church. And the Lord, you know, blessed us throughout that. And we'll share that a little bit more. But, you know, I went off on my path with Bible college and what have you and ministry. And you went on your own path. And it's interesting because though we were both here so close together, we ended up so far. Myself in Minnesota, ultimately in Florida, you in Arizona. And how God has just worked and kind of brought us back together after all these years. And so it's a great blessing. And I just want the folks to get to know a little bit more of Bishop Sam Rojas. So if you don't mind sharing a little bit of your family, the makeup of your family, your wife, your kids, where you're pastoring now.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, Marty. And again, it's an honor to be here with you. And yes, we go way back.
Yes.
We're both kids under your father's ministry. And in fact, your father baptized me.
Yes.
September 18th, 1988.
Wow.
Monte Sinai, Compton, California, many years ago.
Yes, yeah, sir.
I always remember your dad, honor your father.
Amen.
He has a pastor's heart.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
There's a big difference between a pastor that has a pastor's heart.
Amen.
And, you know, other style of leadership.
Sure.
And I learned a lot there.
Yes.
Just, you know, he would stand.
Yes.
At the door, if you remember.
Oh, yeah.
You know, your dad would stand at the door and just greet everyone.
Amen.
That went to church.
Yes.
That day. In fact, now that I'm pastoring there in Arizona, yeah, I do the exact same thing at my local church.
And it worked. I've been borrowing it. I was going to say I stole it, but I've been borrowing the same technique.
It works.
It works.
Contact with the sheep,
yes,
right? And,
yes.
And so, great leadership, great church.
Amen.
You know, a lot of ministers and bishops, yes, have come out of that church.
Yes,
know,
sir.
Bishop Prado, the both Joe,
yes,
and Victor Prado.
Amen.
Bishop President Salazar,
yes,
right?
Amen.
Is now the pastor there. Yourself.
Amen.
And many other ministers have come out from that church, and it's been just a blessing.
Yes.
You know, from there, we went to CLC in Stockton,
okay,
with Brother Haney,
sure,
with UPCI for 4 years. Learned a lot there. When I graduated from CLC, got to Brother David Zuniga, you know, with Montebello.
Sure, sure.
He's the one that actually ordained me, set me aside.
Oh, wow. Praise
worked with him for about 6 years.
Yeah.
It was an all-Spanish church, multicultural, Hondurans, sure, Salvadorans. And
then he's Colombian.
He's Colombian.
So he's also,
oh, yeah, yeah. Tremendous,
yeah,
tremendous man. And so, from there, we transitioned over to Fontana,
yeah,
under Bishop Valverde.
Yes.
We were there for about 10 years.
Yes.
And currently, we're in Arizona.
Okay. What city are you in Arizona?
We're in Glendale.
Glendale,
Arizona.
That's in the greater Phoenix area?
Greater Phoenix area, yeah. It's about 15 minutes north of,
okay,
Phoenix, downtown Phoenix. We're
right
about 20 minutes away from Brother Romo, you know,
sure,
the church,
okay,
there in Arizona. And,
right.
It's been great. It's been
wonderful.
Great. The only thing is it's about 115 degrees today. So I'm
oh,
glad.
So that's you're right. Getting a break here.
I'm getting a break.
And it's hot here for us.
It's hot here, yes. And so we love 100 degree weather in California.
Yes.
Wow. And so we've been there. It's going to be 15 years, Marty.
Wow.
15 years. And, 15 years. We served, obviously, there as a bishop. Amen. And now, you know, my wife and I, my kids, sure. Both my kids are in church.
Praise God.
My daughter, Michaela, runs the live stream there at the church. My son plays drums and now bass. They're praise fully God. Vested into the ministry. My wife is a big blessing, you know, to our life. And and now we're here. We're back at headquarters working. Yeah. And
when you say back, because some folks might not know, you worked at headquarters for a bit.
We did, yeah. Yeah, I did from 2000, I believe, 2000 to 2009, 2008.
Yes. Yeah. What did you do at headquarters, if you don't mind?
Basically, I was the operations manager.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, had the honor of working with Bishop Ademar Rodriguez his last year, and then all of Bishop Daniel Sanchez's term,
sure.
And part of Brother Bishop Valverde's term as well. Worked with many, many great men, Bishop Aguilar, Bishop Fortino.
Sure.
Learned a lot.
Amen. The Lord along the way allowed you to sit under great leaders.
Yes.
And that's a blessing.
You know, it's an amazing blessing, Marty. You have that experience too with Bishop Fortino. Yeah. You know, these men are just driven.
It's interesting because in the process, as you're serving, you know, people are, oh, it's just a job. But as you serve and you're around these men and you see the way situations are handled and if you're wise, you learn. You become a sponge. You grab these things. Oh, yeah. Some people just look at it as a 9-to-5, go do my work, I leave. Yeah. But if you grab these nuggets along the way and just kind of put them, their tools that you're putting in the belt, and ultimately they help. And obviously in your ministry, you know, we've seen the fruit of that as well. So after your time here, you head out to Glendale.
We head out to Glendale. We took over a church there and basically started to work with the people.
Sure.
You know, it was a big... culture shock, going from California, growing up here, my first...
Because your whole life had always been
here. My whole life had been here, and then to go to Arizona
was
a big change for us, especially the culture, the weather, the church. I didn't know the church, you know, Bishop Sanchez, you know, back then, it was still, you're going to go, be obedient, you know, obey the call of God, and, you know, we know what we're doing.
Yes.
And so my first Sunday... in Glendale was the first time in my life
really
had ever been in that church.
Wow.
Yeah.
So when you're installed as pastor,
that was
that's your first exposure to the church.
Ever.
Wow.
I had never been to the building. I had never been to the church. I just obeyed.
That's interesting because we live in a culture today that we want the answer to all the questions before we make a decision.
Yeah.
Faith is going into what I don't see yet, but I know that God's there and He's going to move. And so it's a testament. And this is why I ask these kind of questions before we get into kind of the nitty gritty of what you're doing here in the assembly now, because a lot of people see our board members and they were born. You know, they were born and boom, someone put them there is investment. There is steps of faith along the way that has brought you down this track to where God has you. So you were you were the pastor there. You got installed as pastor first time.
Mm-hmm.
First time you had ever met the church.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd imagine that was quite an adjustment period for you.
It was definitely an adjustment. Sure. Yeah, just learning, you know, learning the people and the church, the area.
Sure.
But I always knew it was God's will.
Amen.
Right? You know when God is working.
And amen.
So before that, I spoke with President Sanchez.
Sure.
And I remember going into his office and sitting down in front of him, and I just looked at him and said, President, I'm just going to ask you for one thing.
Yeah.
Send me where you think God is sending
me. Wow.
And he said, we'll do that.
Yeah.
15 years later, Marty, there's no doubt in my mind, and you know this,
amen.
You know, pastors know this.
Yes.
When God sends you somewhere, He goes with you.
Amen.
You know,
yes.
He confirms, He blesses you. You know, there's struggle, obviously, with everything, right?
Yeah.
And then there's challenges, and, you know, my kids were little, you know, my son was 4, my daughter was 8, But when you're in the will of God,
yes,
you know, God just opened doors and God just moved within the church. And yeah, there was times when I wanted to come back to California, you know, throw the white towel out and just say, hey, come back. And, you know, a few times. But when you're in the will of God, it's a beautiful thing.
Amen. Because
God directs your steps, you know.
Amen. The steps of a righteous man.
That's exactly what I was going to say. Yeah.
They're ordained by God. Yeah. And so when you obey the call, it's like I look at faith like I'm stepping where there's nothing, knowing that as my foot is planted, God's going to be there sustaining me.
Absolutely.
And that has been for you to say 15 years, you said?
15 years, yes.
To think that 15 years ago you went, brand new pastor, green as can be, first day at the church was the day you're installed, to see everything that God has done, you know, and yeah, now we look at not the finished product, but where God has you today, and wow, that's great. But there was a lot of yeses to God along the way that were maybe even a struggle to say yes. Maybe it's like, God, I don't understand here, but I'm going to say yes.
Yes.
You know, and in that obedience and submission, God just, it's like we open God's hands of blessings when we do that.
Right.
You know,
there's no limitation. There's
exactly.
No limitation, right? There's no
that's
ceiling.
A great way
right?
of saying
there's
that.
No ceiling when yes. you. When you say yes to God,
amen.
That's the best decision you can make.
Amen.
As a minister, as a man of God, your family, yes, it's not easy.
Sure.
Of course. But when you're in that perfect zone, the perfect will of God, God just does a work in your life, in your family. Never in my wildest dreams, you know, would I ever think, you know, be bishop of a district or anything like that.
Sure.
You know, most of these things have just come due to that, I think. You know, just obedience, Amen. Serving, loving God's people,
Amen.
You know, having a spirit of a just serving.
Sure.
You know, I've always served, said yes, and that's been the biggest blessing for me, you know,
Amen.
In ministry and just you know, being involved in the mission of the church.
Sure.
Very excited.
Yeah.
Right now, what's going on with our assembly.
Amen.
I believe our president has a great vision for the church. And that's another aspect that I, you know, it's interesting because he was my youth counselor. He was our youth counselor.
In
remember
Compton.
That?
Yes.
And so you and I are in the youth at Compton, and Bishop Salazar at that time, he was Minister Salazar,
exactly.
he was our youth counselor.
Yes.
I never thought, and you know, I was speaking to him the other day, and I told him, did you ever think that we would serve together?
Yeah.
He didn't think, and I didn't think, but that's what God does.
Yes.
Right now, you're here too, and it's an amazing thing.
It's amazing how God just like positions everything where it belongs in his way, in his time. It really, really is. Because, I mean, I remember us going to youth socials at his house.
Right.
Him and our First Lady, Sister Rose, recently married at their house. And, you know, they would have us over. And just to think, like, and that's something I share a lot when I go to, like, youth camps and junior camps. And we look at each other like, oh, it's just Sam. It's just Marty. It's just Philip.
Right.
Excuse me for not following protocol.
Right.
But we look at each other that way. It's just, oh, it's just another person in church.
Yeah.
Not knowing what God already has for us.
Absolutely.
But again, and I think that comes from our experiences. I think that comes from our leaders that have showed us and our obedience to submit to God's will.
Mm-hmm.
I had a mentor once tell me, he says, Marty, you can live in the biggest mansion, but if you're not in God's will, you'll be the most miserable of men.
Mm-hmm.
You can live in a little shack, but if you're in God's will, you'll be the happiest of men.
Absolutely.
And it's just so amazing as we do say those things and we just see the steps of God. So we see your trajectory into ministry, into pastorship. You become bishop of the Arizona district.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. After serving there. And now secretary of social assistance. And I know we have our elections. I know that the pastors vote. I do believe that that's all led by God, led by the Holy Spirit. And maybe we go in thinking, well, with my experience, you know, this would be a good fit. And we all, in our human nature, pastors are like, oh, I could see that brother here or there. But God's wisdom is just so, you know, we've been talking about serving and that heart of serving. And you mentioned it like two or three times already, God's people.
Mm-hmm.
Some people say my church or my people. And, you know, when we keep that perspective, hey, this is God's church.
Absolutely.
These are God's people, serving God's people. In my personal opinion, your area specifically now serves the Apostolic Assembly, serves God's people in a very, very personal way.
Yes.
It's a very broad area that you have, and I believe that God is expanding that territory still mm-hmm. of social assistance, and I believe there's so much more that God is going to continue to give you along the way. I think he's putting pieces in place for you, but what does that feel like now, or where do you see that now, the Department of Social Assistance?
Well, the Department of Social Assistance is I believe, the Department of God.
Yes. Right?
If I could say that sure, with all due sure. respect to all of my other colleagues, right? Because we basically minister to the widows, to the orphans, to the needs of the church,
yes.
right? And so primarily our pastors,
yes.
right? Because we believe that all pastors, together with their wives and their children,
yes.
have to be healthy.
Amen.
You know, healthy leadership.
Amen.
So we recently, as you know, we launched a new ministry,
Amen.
The Bridge Counseling Ministry for That's pastors.
Wonderful.
And so this is going to be a ministry that any pastor in the Apostolic Assembly yes. can call, get the proper help. Doesn't matter what they're going through.
Sure.
You know, this is we want our pastors to be healthy, and so that's one of the ministries. Obviously, Embracing Hope
sure.
For many, many, many years has worked to minister to those people that have cancer, terminal illnesses. We have our deaf ministry that you're
yes.
a big part of that with your local church. We thank you for that.
Amen.
And many others, right, yes. that we're going to be starting. We're going to be starting a blended families
wow.
ministry, which
That's
is
wonderful.
You know, a big need
yes.
in our churches
yes.
to deal with the nuances of a blended family
sure.
and all the new, you know, areas there. And so along with that, you know, we also help when someone passes away,
yes.
right? When we attend funerals, and we try to provide just the support
Amen.
To our membership. We have a benevolent fund that helps yes. our members in the time of need, disaster relief.
Yes.
In fact, we are looking into going to Hawaii possibly within the
sure.
next week or two to offer relief over
Amen.
There. And so it's I believe it's at the heart of God.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
To help those that are in need, and
sure.
to also minister primarily to our pastors, because we feel that the church is about to grow in an exponential way. But in order for that to happen, Marty, as you know,
yes.
healthy leadership is
Amen.
So important, right?
Amen.
Be right in your spirit as
yeah.
a pastor. Pastors go through so many things, you know, depression, loneliness. They go through doubt in their
But you're
ministry.
A pastor. You're not supposed to go through those things,
Hey,
right?
You're supposed to be Superman, right?
Exactly.
You know, you're supposed to get up on Sunday and
sure.
everything's fine. The congregation sees that you're
yeah.
doing well, and they think that life is great.
Yes.
No, a lot of our pastors, you know, need this area where they can go and just have the conversation like you
yes.
and I can have.
Amen.
You know, you and I can have at any point,
yes.
you know, I can call you and say, hey, Marty, I'm going through this,
Amen.
And you'll understand me.
Yes.
You won't judge me. You won't feel like, you know, what's wrong with Bishop
yeah,
Sam, right?
Exactly.
And, yeah. and more than anything, you'll pray for me,
yes,
right?
For sure.
And so this particular ministry is going to be focused on our pastors.
That's wonderful.
Right? So,
That's
yeah.
wonderful. From what I understand from this ministry as well, it's completely confidential.
It's completely confidential.
Which
right.
is, I think, opens a lot of door for transparency and for
Absolutely.
People to kind of let their guard down and just really, truly share
Absolutely.
Where they're at
yeah.
with the confidence that, hey, I can do this and I can have the counseling I need. I can get through this without feeling like who's watching, who's saying. Ever since I've been in pastorship now again, because I've pastored previously two different churches, but now here in Riverside, it's the Lord, man, almost immediately connected me with Dr. Juan Dominguez.
Yes.
And we started talking, and I said, man, now more than ever, I understand the need for me as a pastor to have someone to go to.
Yes.
Because I'm carrying the weight of the church.
Wow.
I have brothers that'll come right before church and dump all their problems on me, mm-hmm. and then they'll go in church to sing and dance and shout, and I'm supposed to preach
yeah.
after all these, you know,
yeah.
heavy things that are just, you know, or you get out of church after a long day and I need to talk. It's an emergency. 911, Pastor. I got to talk to you now. And they dump these things. And so, like, where do you go? And so the Lord, like, put something. Someday the Lord will allow me to share this. But, you know, what happens when the encourager needs encouragement?
Right.
What happens when the leader, the one that is taking you forward, is going through moments that hey, if I'm not right, I might lead the wrong way.
Right.
I might not take God's people in the direction that they should go because I'm not right. I need to be where I need to be. Definitely. So I think that is so key right now. And I thank you for having the foresight of doing that. And I pray that as this ministry expands, that God will continue to open the doors. I can't help but to remember back to our former president, Bishop Fortino. I remember he used to tell Bishop Quesada, who was social assistance director at the time, he used to tell him, you are the pastor to our pastors.
Right.
You're the one that is there in the moment of their needs. Mm-hmm. You're the one that's there in the moments of crisis, in the moments of hurt, in the moments of pain. And you're the face in that respect to the church in those moments of crisis and of need. And so I think it's great that, again, talking about that pastoral heart, mm-hmm. I think it's great that God has you there. And I believe that he's prepared you for that. What kind of projects are you looking at outside of what's already formed or maybe projects that right now the church isn't really, it hasn't been on the forefront, needs that are there, things of that nature. Well, you mentioned like orphanages.
They're all related. Yeah, yes. We have a project in Africa.
Okay.
Kenya, Africa. We're working together with Bishop Moran, you know.
Oh, okay.
International missions.
I was there when we broke ground.
Yes. You were there.
Okay.
Yeah, so we broke ground on an orphanage in Kenya.
Yeah.
Africa. And so on behalf of the Department of International Missions and Social Assistance, we're going to build an orphanage in Kenya.
That is
and
wonderful.
So that's a project that's ongoing.
Sure.
In fact, like you mentioned, we already broke ground there. And so
that's
one. We also have other ministries. You know, like we are thinking about a grief share ministry. We had recently some pastors, right, that widowed.
Yes.
And also, you know, obviously pastors' wives. So the process of grief, right? We had a pastor who lost their son, you know, dear son, you know, recently in New York City, Pastor Adam Lopez. And, you know, how do we help them? How do we help them navigate through that process of grief and you know, the stages of grief, that type of a ministry?
It's wonderful.
Also, special needs.
That is
a ministry that every church, I believe, should have.
Amen.
Because we have special needs kids everywhere.
And as you know, that for me is very dear because my sister, she's with the Lord now.
Yes.
But Becky, you know, lived a very long life, lived to be 60, had Down syndrome.
Yes.
And how I wished that she would have those opportunities when she was younger. But it's beautiful to see that we're looking at that on how we can bless our special needs kids.
You have a lot of fond memories of your sister Becky, you know, visiting your house.
And amen.
She's there. And, beautiful memories of our youth there with her. And you know, we have that ministry that basically is very important.
Yes.
You know, for pastors to just think outside of the box and really reach out. Deaf ministry, special needs ministry, single adults.
Yes.
You have a lot of single adults,
sure.
People that are divorced, things like that. You know, so all of those kind of go in conjunction, blended families.
Sure.
And just helping the pastor. Give them resources.
Sure.
So we're looking toward that for the next few years here with the help of God.
Wonderful. Yeah. Wonderful. So if you're speaking, I'm going to go back just a little bit because we start coming to a close here. But if you're speaking to that young leader, male or female, but that young leader that's feeling a tug on their heart, feeling like, I know there's more. I just sat down with a young lady last night and she was kind of all over the map, but in a good way.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor, I've been praying and I feel the call of God here. And, you know, I love praying with people at the altar, but I don't know if I should. Is that okay? Is it not okay? I love helping the homeless and people that are going through drug addiction. And to see a young lady that maybe nowadays, you know, could be so self-consumed and what are my needs or what do I want? But just like, I want to help people. And and I think we're living in a generation right now of young people that they're really involved in the social needs that are around us. And they kind of I don't want to say there's a disconnect because I don't think there is. It just, they want to do more different from what we've normally done as a church. And so what advice would you give them and how they can take that energy, that desire that they have to be able to bless, whether it be their church, their communities? What are some of the things that they can do? Like, what are the, if I'm just like, I'm a young man, young leader, even maybe a pastor, it's like, man, I'm in my community. I feel like there's more than I can do for God's people. Mm-hmm. There's other ways to reach God's people. Mm-hmm. What are some of the advice that you would give them?
Well, the first thing I would say is to be true to your calling.
Yes.
Right? And then creativity is very important. I think we have yet to see the best ministries in the Apostolic Assembly.
I agree with you 100%.
Think outside the box.
Yes.
What can we do to reach, right?
Amen.
Build the church.
Amen.
I think that we have the model of the strategy of Jesus, which I believe in wholeheartedly. Life group, we have that at our church. But we also need to think outside the box in the sense that, okay, what new ministry are you going to create, right? We have so many creatives within the church that I feel that God is just speaking to them to bring out a new ministry.
Amen.
What new ministry are you going to bring out and establish and launch, right? Be a pilot program.
Amen.
We are open to new ideas.
Amen.
If any one of these young people feel that call, they are more than welcome to call me. We can meet with them. We can form a coalition. And just look at ways on how the assembly can administer to the community.
Amen.
Get outside of the box. We are reaching people from the English community.
Amen.
We are now in India and in Africa, where many years ago we were not.
Yes.
And I believe that the assembly is going to go even more global.
Amen.
And so that's going to entail reaching out to different cultures, different languages, and it's just an amazing thing, opportunities.
Amen.
But more than anything, Marty, I think just follow the call.
Yes.
Right? I think every young person needs at least three relationships, a mentor, a friend, and an apprentice, right? Like Paul.
Yes.
Paul had Gamaliel that led him for 14 years. Paul had Barnabas, who was the son of consolation.
Amen.
Barnabas was a guy that he could let his hair down.
Yeah.
Just be Paul. Paul was just Paul with Barnabas. It's like you and me, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Like I can let the little hair that I have left, and you can let the little hair you have left. But we also need Timothys.
Yes.
And I believe that Timothy generation within the Apostolic Assembly is going to usher in the greatest revival we've ever had, Marty.
Amen.
I believe it. I see a hunger.
I agree with you, and I believe that the revival is going to be so great. I believe it was Pastor Omar Cortez last year's NYA here in our area. Right at the end, he said something that to me was so eye-opening for me at my age, where I am right now in my ministry. He says, your generation is going to experience maybe even a greater revival than what we have, but it will be different than ours.
Mm-hmm.
And our generation needs to be okay with that.
Completely agree with you.
You know, and so when you're saying we have to create this space so that creativity can flourish, not squash it,
right,
but guide it, direct it, and say, run with it. Let's do this. Someone did that for us.
Yes.
You know, someone launched us into ministry. And so I'm so grateful that we have someone in your position that has that heart, that is willing to receive those ideas, those thoughts, and to form, amen, these groups to be able to reach those areas. I know we've talked a lot, and I've shared some of my ideas, and I pray that as God blesses us there in the city that we're in of Riverside and opens and expands together. And it's interesting because it all ties back in with the strategy of Jesus, but kind of creating spaces of taking that outside of what we've normally seen and say, you know what, there's other areas that we can now apply that into.
Definitely,
you know?
Definitely. Yeah. And it's something that we have to be open to.
Yes.
I believe that, you know, if I may speak for the board, right, and our president, I believe that this board has that open mentality to this generation.
Amen.
We are preparing the church, not for us, but for our children and our grandchildren.
Amen.
And I tell my church, I am not going to be the last apostolic in my family.
Amen.
And that's not going to happen because my kids are already baptized.
Amen.
And my grandchildren. So I'm preparing the church right now for my grandchildren.
Amen.
You know, the ministries that they're going to get involved with.
Yes, sir.
And so we're open. You know, we are open to great ideas. Obviously, our structure, our belief system is going to continue to stay the same, strong.
Amen.
You know, our doctrinal stance is strong more than ever before.
Yes, sir.
More than ever before.
Amen.
But these new ministries, these kids are going to shock us.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
God is going to do something great. Yeah. I already feel it.
Amen.
I sense a hunger within the young people, and our young people are just hungry to do something for God.
Amen.
Our job is to release them.
Amen.
And guide them, like
Amen.
You said.
Amen.
Pray for them.
Yes.
And let God bring up this Joshua generation.
Yes, sir.
Right? And, you know, the Moseses of our day, you know, praise God for that. You know, the foundations are great, but God is moving now in
yes,
a
sir.
Great way, and I'm excited to see it.
Amen.
Excited to see
Amen.
It.
Amen. Well, Bishop Sam, thank you so much for taking time out of your very busy schedule. It has truly been a blessing. You and I could talk on forever and enjoy it. Everyone would probably be tuned off and we'll still be talking, but it's such a blessing, and I really do thank you for taking this time. And I thank God for kind of reuniting us in this stage of ministry where we're at. It's a blessing. You and your wife are recently with us, and we're a great blessing there in Riverside Apostolic Church, and we thank you for that. If there's one last word that you would like to share with our viewers, please go ahead and do so.
Yes, thank you. We just want to thank you for tuning in today, and it's been an honor to be on the Axis with Pastor Marty. And we just want to let you know that we are here for you. We are here to serve. It's an honor to have been here. And God bless you. Let's move forward with the vision of our president to build the church and expand the kingdom of God through evangelism and discipleship.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. God bless you. Have a great night.
Amen. Thank you so much, Bishop Sam. It's been a privilege and honor to have you with us. You can definitely feel, as you were saying, the heart of our Bishop President and everything that we're seeing, everyone that has come through. You see, even though they're working in various different areas and different focuses, you can see the heart of our Bishop President. I believe the heart of God that he placed this vision within our president. So we thank God for that, and we, feeding off of that, want to thank especially our Bishop, President Bishop Salazar, for this opportunity of being able to have this show called The Access. Amen. We know that Bishop Fortino, before he was leaving, was already moving everything around for this to happen. And we thank God for Bishop Salazar continuing that vision and expanding that vision, the Apostolic Assembly Board, and everyone that's given us this honor of being able to be part of this. I really want to give a big shout out and thank you to our amazing team. Without them, I'm just a man in a seat with a mic, but they're the ones that make the magic happen. So I'm so grateful for Brother Dominic Moschetti, Brother Cesar Perez, and Sister Christy Perez. They're an amazing team that God has placed us together with. And I believe that as we continue to expand the kingdom of God, of building the church through these means, that God will continue to open new doors and give us access to new areas within the kingdom of God. So thank you again for tuning in. We invite you to continue to follow the Apostolic Assembly via Facebook and via YouTube. We're also on Instagram. And through these means, you'll be able to go ahead and receive future shows as they come out. Make sure that you not just follow, but you turn on your notifications, so that way you can receive these shows as they're coming out. We have other wonderful shows that have already started and others that are about to begin. And we thank God that he's expanding these means of communication. So thank you once again. May God bless each and every one of you. And we'll see you soon on our next show. God bless you.